A 74-year-old female has a bulging liver clot after a tooth extraction. Check out the full surgery to treat this lesion today on the Open Reduction. Welcome to the Open Reduction, your channel covering all topics oral and maxillofacial surgery. I'm Dr. Tom Bolten, and today we're watching the surgical treatment of a liver clot. If you haven't yet, check out the video I posted before this one, which reviews this patient's health history and clinical course. The last time I treated this patient, she had discontinued her Eliquis but stayed on her Plavix. Now, she has been back on both these medications for about a week. Simply removing this liver clot is not going to be sufficient. I must anticipate more bleeding after this clot is gone, and if I don't address this, she may end up back in the office or in the emergency room. I anesthetize the area and then excise around this lesion with a 15 blade. After I isolate the lesion, I remove it. Next, I cure at the socket and remove any fibrinous clot material. I remove all tissue to healthy bone. Everything is visible now, and I can see oozing from the walls of the extraction socket. It is not enough to place gel foam in a couple sutures. I need to obtain a watertight primary closure to ensure hemostasis. To do this, I make a large vertical incision along the anterior aspect of the extraction socket. The key to this advancement flap is a tension-free closure. If this tissue is under any tension, the flap will break down and fail. I score the periosteum until I can advance this flap over the extraction socket with no resistance. I rinse thoroughly and place gel foam within the socket. Now, I'm going to obtain a watertight closure using 3-0 vicryl sutures. My first suture is just distal to tooth number 29. I then place multiple sutures along the alveolar crest, starting at number 31 and then moving anteriorly. Finally, I close the vertical release incision. I monitor for a long time in the office to confirm hemostasis. I saw this patient back the next day and there was no bleeding. I then saw her back 1 week later and then at 2 weeks to remove the sutures. She did great and everything healed very well. Thanks so much for watching. Please click those like and subscribe buttons and check out the channel for more interesting OMFS cases. Also, visit my website, theopenreduction.com, for your continuing education needs. I'm Dr. Tom Bolten. I'll catch you next time on The Open Reduction.